think that this album is by far the best record that Old Crow has made in the past 19 years of making recordings, and I think it's the best live show we've ever put on. When I stone you and you're trying to be so good. I don't think Old Crow would be a band if it hadn't have been for Bob Dylan, but more importantly, I don't think that the world of popular music would be half as rich without Bob Dylan's efforts. I would not feel so all alone. Everybody must get stoned. There had never been anything like this in Nashville before. Bob, being such a trailblazer in so many fields, he came to Nashville as an outsider artist before anybody else did. He utilized the country music sessions players and made a very not country record. Sooner or later, one of us must know. I really did try to get close to you. Sometimes it gets so hard to care. It was a lot of work to get ready for it, but once we sat down and or stood up and started playing, it only took about an hour and a half to make this album. We were a little nervous when it started sinking in that we were gonna learn all of this music and that we were gonna play it once. And that was it. Ain't it clear that I just don't feel. I think by tackling Blonde on Blonde, we were able to embody the kind of music exploration that we are asking other people to do too. You know, these songs, yeah, Bob wrote them, but they belong to all of us. I mean, in the case of Blonde on Blonde, that's a Nashville music scene event, a great one. And so for anybody that's wearing a t-shirt with Johnny Cash pushing his middle finger up at you, I also say, hey, just hold up that blurry picture of Bob Dylan. That's Nashville. That's just as Nashville as Coal Miner's Daughter. I'm excited about helping people see that. And in order to do that, you gotta go out and make Bob's big first Nashville record, remake it. I can't make it without you. If it didn't feel so